Using the given matrices, you want to find a certain products or sums. So the first thing that we're going to try to figure out is AB, the product of the matrix A and B. So as you know, AB would mean that we would have to determine if the product is possible. So notice that A is 2x2 matrix, right? 2x2, because it has two rows and two columns. This first number denotes the number of rows of the matrix, and the second number denotes the number of columns. Okay, so 2x2 matrix, it's a square matrix, that is. However, B is 2x3 matrix, right? Two rows and three columns. So 2x3. Now, the only way this is possible if the inner numbers, these two numbers, are the same. So if they were not the same, then this product AB would not be possible. So since they are the same, your final result, the product itself, is going to be 2x3. So you're going to write the first number and the last number. So the outer numbers, basically, from left to right, 2x3. So your result is going to be 2x3 matrix, right? The same matrix in size as the matrix B, right? That's going to be your resulting matrix. So let's see what that's going to be. How are we going to find the entries of the 2x3 matrix AB? So first, let's write, I'm going to write A here, once again, 2, 0, -4, 6. And then I'm going to write B once again, 1, 5, -7, 3, 2, 0. So the way you're going to do that first, you're going to obviously find entries. It's going to be this size, as we just determined, 2x3 matrix. So you're going to find first the first row and column number, right? So the entry, the first entry you're going to find is going to pertain to the position of the first row and the first column. So now that you know it's going to be first row and first column, how are you going to find the product? Well, you're going to use the first row of matrix A, first row of matrix A, and first column of matrix B, right? Because if you use the first row and first column, you will get basically this number that we're trying to find in the resulting matrix 2x3, which is going to be the first row and first column entry, right? So how are you going to use these numbers? Well, let me write AB. So AB is going to be 2x3 matrix, right? The same size as this one. So we're going to do 2 times 1. Well, I should make it probably bigger, something like this. 2 times 1 plus 0 times 5. That's how you do the operation. Okay, now let's do, so that's just the entry that is instead of this one. There's 5 more entries to be found for this matrix AB, right? 5 more entries. How are you going to find the second row, first column? Well, again, second row, first column. That should give you a hint as to what you're going to use in multiplication. Second row, first column. So you're going to multiply, you're going to use these two numbers now. You're going to use, I should erase these colors because we don't need them now because we have different operation. Okay. So this is untouched, right? So now we're going to use, since we're trying to find something instead of this 5 here right below, we're going to use the 5 is in the position of second row, first column. So second row, -4, -6, we'll deal with 1 and 5. So the same way, -4 times 1 plus 6 times 5. 6 times 5. Okay, I might run out of space, so I will probably need to expand this a little more. Okay, so now we found two entries. What about instead of negative 7? Where's that in position? That's first row, second column, right? First row, second column, right? So that's where the negative 7 is. That's the position of that number. First row, second number, second column. So that means we will use the first row and second column to find the number instead of negative 7. So 2 and 0 and negative 7 and 3. So 2 times negative 7. Let me put this in parentheses. Negative 7 plus 0 times 3. Okay? Now I'm just going to do faster work. So now we're going to find instead of 3. So it's going to be second row, second column. Second row, negative 4 and 6. Deal with negative 7 and 3, second column. So negative 4 times negative 7. Plus 6 times 3. Okay? Now instead of 2, first row, second column, third column, right? To find what is going to be instead of 2. 2 times 2, 2 times 2, plus 0 times 0. Now instead of the 0, the final entry that we need to find is going to be second row, third column, right? Negative 4 times 2 plus 6 times 0. There we go. So now let's let's actually simplify this so we have only whole numbers instead of any products or sums, right? 2 plus 0, that's 2. Negative 14 plus 0, negative 14. 4 plus 0, 4. Negative 4 plus 30, that's 26. 28 plus 18. 28 plus 18, that's 46. Negative 8 plus 0, negative 8. There you go. You just found your AB, the product of two matrices, A and B. This is going to be the final matrix. And as you can see, it is indeed the same size 2x3 matrix as the B matrix, right? And as we determined here in the product. Now, the second example is to find BA. But before you try to use this technique that we've just discussed, first note whether BA is possible. You have to determine that first, right? Because if it is possible, then you can actually do some algebra. So what is going to be BA? B is going to be this time 2x3, right? You're switching these rows basically. You're going to write 2x3 first, and then you're going to write 2x2 first. 2x2. Now note the problem. The problem is these two inner numbers are different. If they're different, does it mean it's possible to multiply B and A if you put B on the left side and then A on the right? No, that's impossible. So it's undefined. So if it's undefined, we shouldn't even try to multiply, because, and you can see why it would not work. Because if you multiply 1 with 2 and then add that to negative 7 and negative 4, the 2 doesn't get anything, right? Because there's nothing underneath the negative 4, right? 1 and negative 7 get 2 and negative 4 respectively to multiply, but then 2 doesn't get any number. You see? That's another way of looking at it when you're trying to use this technique of multiplication. But anyway, this is a shortcut to it. This is a shortcut. Find the inner numbers not matching. That's it. Undefined. Now the third example, the final example, is to find the trace of 4e transpose minus d. So first we're going to find e transpose. So e transpose is going to basically, you're going to look at this diagonal, the main diagonal that is, and you're going to basically switch these numbers around. You're going to switch places, basically. This and this. And finally, this and this. Okay? So basically, the main diagonal will remain. So basically, there's you switch these numbers symmetrically, right? You're gonna place 1 instead of 6, 6 instead of 1, and 7 instead of 0, 0 instead of 7, etc., etc. You're gonna switch them around, these numbers. And the main diagonal numbers will remain there because they are the axis of, you can treat them as like as line of symmetry, right? So these numbers remain. So we can write them as 0, 1, 2. They're intact. So 3 is gonna go here, negative 5 is gonna go there, 0 is gonna go here, 7 is going there, 1 is going here, and 6 is going there. There you go. You just found the E transpose. For E transpose means you basically multiply each of the entries by 4. So 0, negative 20, 28, 12, 4, 24. Let me see. 0, 4, 8, right? That's the 4e transpose. Now, what is going to be 4e transpose minus d, right? We're working slowly, right? We're finding the we're kind of using the PEMDAS system of for the matrices, right? The operations, which operations take precedence, etc., etc., right? So 4e transpose minus d, that's going to be, they have to be the same size, right? So 4e transpose must be the same size as d. Is it true? D is 3x3 matrix, and so is 4e transpose. So that works. So this is not undefined. So basically what is going to happen is, it's going to be the same size matrix, obviously, because in order to subtract, you will have to have the same size, which is good. Right, 3x3 and 3x3. So this one comes first. So you basically subtract in each of the entries, respective entries, in the same position. Right, so it's going to be 0. I should write it probably bigger, so you can see what the operations would be. So 0 minus, right, the first row, first column, minus the first row and first column of the d. Right, so negative 2. Then negative 20 minus 1. 28 minus 8. 12, the second row, 12 minus 3. 4 minus 0. 24 minus 2. 0 minus 4, 4 minus negative 6, 8 minus 3. Okay, so that simplifies to 0 minus negative 2, 2, negative 21, 20, 9, 4, 22, negative 4, 10, and 5. Okay, so that is going to be the 4e transpose minus d. So now you need to find the trace of that. So the trace of that matrix that we just found is going to be the sum of the entries located on the main diagonal. So remember, just like we discussed the main diagonal here, however, the main diagonal entries are different now, right? Because we performed the operation, subtracted the d from the 4e transpose, right? So the main diagonal numbers are different now. But the main diagonal principle is the same. It's the same types of numbers that you locate, right? I mean, in the same location, right? The location doesn't change. It's still the main diagonal, right? So the trace is going to be the sum of these numbers, 2 plus 4, plus 5, and that is equal to 11. There you go. You just solved 3 types of problems, one of them being undefined successfully. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.